So we are wrapping up our time in Amsterdam on the train now, headed to the airport. And we had a really, really good time. My recommendation is to get out there and explore the city. And that's what we did. So we took a little bit of time to talk about it afterwards. See, she tried to do it off the camera. It was a pretty good time. Pretty interesting time. Now we have to learn the lay of the land in London all over again. This is crazy. All right, back to the hustle and bustle of the airport. We actually discovered that KLM has a lounge, and not just one, but several lounges. You have to go through security, and you can access the lounges that way. But once you get done with the lounge, you have to go through immigrations. So here it is. And let me tell you, this lounge was fabulous, fabulous. So much seating. So much space. And again, this is one. I think there may have been, who knows, maybe 15 or so lounges. One of my favorite parts of the lounge is the fact that all of the liquor is self-served. So all you gotta do is walk right on up, pour your own poison, and enjoy. Really awesome option here. And just like that, we're on the beach. No, I'm just kidding. This is actually an awesome wallpaper we found tucked away in a nice area of the lounge. It has charging ports, probably about two or three per table. And we just sat here and got some work done. Editing. Yeah, so once you get past immigrations, then you end up in this part of the airport. Yeah, it's pretty basic. Nothing fancy to see here, but we catch a bus to the plane on the tarmac where several planes were, and then we were off to the skies. So I dozed off, and then I woke up to this. Has anybody ever seen a windmill form in the middle of the ocean? This is crazy. Now we are starting our descent into the London area. Some very good aerial views of the city coming up here. This was a really gorgeous view, and once we hit the ground, you will see what a lot of these gorgeous buildings and whatnot are. And we have touchdown. We are in London and excited to explore what the city has to offer. So as you can see, it's the next day. When we touched down, we had an hour and a half train ride. I'm sorry, not a train ride. Hour and a half Uber to our airport. Oh my God, it was exhausting. We were hungry, tired, so we just laid it down. We got up the next morning and we are off exploring the city. Today is actually Danielle and I's anniversary. So have a whole lot planned for this day. We plan to do a on and off bus tour around the city. And we're also doing dinner at a very high-end restaurant. I think it's called Aqua Chard. It's said to have some of the most gorgeous views in London. So yeah, we are excited. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy the sights. Ahead is our first view of the Chard building where we'll have dinner at tonight. Here we began our crossing of the Tower Bridge. This bridge is the iconic bridge of London that most people confuse for the London Bridge, but it's not the London Bridge. It is actually called the Tower Bridge. The London Bridge is actually just a basic bridge that looks like any other bridge you would see, but this one is called the Tower Bridge. Isn't it gorgeous? Next, we are approaching the Tower of London. This was an iconic fortress, royal palace, and an infamous prison. Here we get our first views of the London Eye. This is a Ferris wheel that is iconic to the London skyline. We'll get some more close-up views of this in the days to come. Well, everyone knows about this iconic clock. This is our first glimpse of Big Ben. And it is definitely big. Very pristine, and it's some great views in the next clips. Now we are on the on and off bus, and we are traveling down the iconic Regent Street. This place has a lot of shops. It's very close to some of your high-end stores and luxury brands. This is also the street where we got a chance to have our afternoon tea for our anniversary, Regent Street. Alright, it's now the evening and we are going to celebrate our anniversary. This is the Chard building and we are having dinner at Aqua Chard, which is up on the 32nd floor. You can see here we have phenomenal 180 views of London and the Thames River. We were blessed to have one of the best seats in the house, where we sat right at the window and got to enjoy this phenomenal view of the city. And after dinner, we had cocktails. I will tell you that this experience was awesome. They have craft cocktails that they curate right there at the bar. Some very experienced bartenders. We had a really good time at this bar. So the icing on the cake was this gorgeous sunset. It gets no better than this. What a great way to start our trip to London. Enjoy the sunset. We'll see you tomorrow on day 2 of our London adventures.